And the last group of people that will be called stand up. And those people will be الَّذِينَ يَحْمَدُونَ اللَّهَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. All those people who thank Allah at the time of happiness, at the time of difficulty, stand up. The Prophet ﷺ says that these people will stand up. And once they stand up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, you also go into paradise. And once these people enter into paradise, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start the hisab kitab for the rest of the people. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will start accounting the rest of the servants for their deeds. So three groups of people will say, you know, you're not even going to wait for the accounting. Three groups of people up and in paradise. الَّذِي تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَلَى الْمَضَاجِعِ. Those whose shoulders depart and part their leave their beddings at the time in the middle of the night for tahajjud salah. The second, those are الَّذِينَ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ, whose wealth in the transactions did not take them away from the remembrance of Allah. And the third, الَّذِينَ يَحْمَدُونَ اللَّهَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, those that praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time of difficulty, at the time of joy. And then after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted all these people entry into paradise, then the rest of the people will be called, okay, now it's time to deal with other people. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that whoever has been given four things, he has been given all the good of this world. Whoever has been given four things, he has been granted all the good of this world. The first thing, lisan al shakir, lisan al dakir, قلب شاكر بدن صابر مرأة مؤمنة زوجة مؤمنة صالحة. Four things. The first thing is لسان ذاكرة, a tongue that is always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person that has been granted four things, he has been granted the good of all, everything this world could ever provide to this person, anything the good can offer to this person, he has it all. The first of the four things is لسان ذاكرة, a tongue that is in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second, قلب شاكر, the heart that is always thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third, بَغَنًا صَابِرًا, that body which is always patient in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fourth thing that if a person has, he has been granted the good of all this world, زَوْجَةً مُؤْمِنَةً صَالِحًا, a pious, believing wife. A wife that is pious and she's believing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of our wives that are already married, those of us that are married, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them pious and make them strong in their belief. And those of us that are to be married, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you beyond that, inshaAllah, Allah Aziz. So this, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned this in one hadith. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that ما, and I narrated this hadith at the beginning of the lecture, ما أنعم الله على عبد من نعمة صغرت أو كبرت فقال الحمد لله إلا كان قد أعطي مما أخذ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He showers a person with a blessing and a bounty, no matter how big it is, no matter how small it is, if he says alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always give him more. This is the key to success. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers me and you, gives any of us a bounty, big or small, however small the bounty may be in our eyes, however big the bounty may be in our eyes, if we say alhamdulillah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this bounty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will always give us more in return. And I finish off with the last incident that teaches us a lesson of life. This hadith, Imam Ghazali rahimahullah has also narrated it in his Ahya. He narrates from Ata. It's a beautiful incident. SubhanAllah, a very beautiful incident and teaches us a very big lesson of life. I'll narrate the incident and translate it from the book. رُوِيَ عَنْ عَطَاءٍ أَنَّهُ قَالَ. It is narrated by Ata. Ata was a tabi'i. He says, أَنَّهُ قَالَ. He says, he narrates the incident. دَخَلْتُ عَلَى عَائِشَةَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهَا فَقُلْ. I came to Hazrat Aisha رضي الله عنها and I said to her, أخبرينا بأعجب ما رأيتي من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Tell me something unique that you saw in the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Ata'a is coming to the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم had parted this world, and he's saying to Hazrat Aisha, tell me something unique you saw in the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فبكت. Hazrat Aisha began to cry. The memories came back. The life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came back. Tears came to her eyes, and she says, وَقَالَ وَأَيُّ شَأْنُهُ لَمْ يَكُنْ عَجَبًا. You tell me, which one of the things of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't astonishing? Which one of the things of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't unique? Tell me one thing of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam which wasn't of the highest caliber. There was nothing beyond that. And then she says that أَتَعْنِي لَيْلَةً فَدَخَلَ مَعِي فِي فِرَاشِ. That one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she begins to narrate an incident. That one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came home. And he lied down with his Aisha radiallahu anha in the same bedding. حَتَّى مَسَّ جِلْدِي جِلْدَهُ. Until their bodies were touching. And then she said, ثُمَّ قَالَ. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, So the Prophet ﷺ is lying down next to his wife, as Aisha radiallahu anha. And then he says to his Aisha, Ya ibnat Abi Bakr, the old daughter of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anha, give me permission, ata'abbadu li rabbi, I should go and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's lying down, he just come home, lying down next to his wife. Me and you would never think of this. And here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying to his wife, has Aisha radiallahu anha, look at the etiquette first of all. What is he saying? He's seeking permission from his wife first. Me and you do whatever we want to without seeking permission from our spouses ever. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaches us a lesson that always take their thought into consideration too. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam takes permission from him. It's very big. Here is the Prophet of Allah, the Messenger of Allah, the greatest of all creation, and he's seeking refuge from his wife. Me and you treat our wives as if they have no status at all in our house. As if they have no say in our life at all. And here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the smallest thing, he's seeking permission from his wife. He says, give me permission, I should go and worship my Lord. فَقَالَتْ قُلْتُ إِنِّي أُحِبُّ قُرْبَكُ لَكِنِّي أُوْثِرَ هَوَاكَ فَأَذِنْتُ لَهُ. She says that, I said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the truth is, I love being close to you. Being close to you is beyond anything. But now I'm going to give preference to your desire over mine. And she says, I gave the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam permission. فَقَامْ The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he stood up, he went to the water, he performed wudu. وَلَمْ يَكْفُرْ صَبَّ الْمَا The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he performed wudu with very little water. ثُمَّ قَامَ يُصَلِّي The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then began to pray. Now she's describing, picture us. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has just left his wife. And as Aisha radiallahu anha, she's waiting there. She doesn't want the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to leave. But she's giving preference to the desire of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam over herself. Again, a lesson for the wives now. Now not always should we place ourselves as the focal point. Sometimes we should give preference to other people over ourselves. Especially the spouse. So here she says, I give preference to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's desire, and I lied there. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he stood up, he performed his wudu, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam began to pray. ثُمَّ قَامَ يُصَلِّ فَبَكَ The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he stood praying in front of Allah and he started crying. حَتَّى سَعَلَتْ دُمُوعَهُ عَلَى صَدْرِهِ The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was crying and crying and crying and crying until his tears they rolled onto the chest of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine the tears of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanallah. And then she says, ثُمَّ رَكَعَ And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went into ruku. He bowed down in front of Allah, فَبَكَ He started crying even more. And then she says, ثُمَّ سَجِدَ فَبَكَ And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went into prostration, فَبَكَ He started crying again. ثُمَّ رَفَعَ رَأْسَهُ فَبَكَ And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he stood up from his sajda, he sat up from his sajda, and he started crying again. فَلَمْ يَزَلْ كَذَلِكَ يَبْكِي حَتَّى جَاءَ بِلَالًا فَأَذَّنَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sat there all night crying and crying, crying and crying in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until Bilal radiallahu anhu, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that it was salah time now. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam heard it was salah time, he finished off his salah and then Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anhu, she rushed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam before he left. فقلت يا رسول الله ما يبكي وقد غفر الله لك ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر. She says, Oh Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why were you crying so much? Haven't your sins already been forgiven? The sins of the past, the sins that you will ever do. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even committed any sins, even the Prophet of Allah is ma'asum, he is free of sins altogether. But yet, even if you were to commit any sin, Allah has already forgiven it. Why are you crying? فقال أفلا أكون عبدا شكورا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Should I not be a thankful servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَلِمَ لَا أَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ Why should I not do this? وَقَدْ أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيَّ إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِّأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ He mentions that should I not be a thankful servant to Allah? And why should I not do this when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, indeed in the creation of the skies and the earth, and the coming and going of the night and the day, there is a sign of those who are intellectual. Those who remember Allah while they are standing, while they are sitting, while they are lying down. And they ponder on the creation of Allah. And then they say, Oh Allah, you have not created this in vain. Oh Allah, you are glorified. Save us from the fire of hell. This is the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should all learn how to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So closing off again, inshallah, we finish off today's gathering. But I want to drill the points to take on home with us again. Very important. The first thing, we have to recognize the bounties of Allah. Amen. Very important. How do we recognize the bounty of Allah? Whenever we see any bounty, three things. What is the bounty? How does the bounty benefit us? And the third thing, who provided us with this bounty? Three questions about every single bounty. Whether it be our the cap on our head, the glasses we're wearing, the shoes we're wearing, the keys that we have, whatever it is. Three bounties, three questions every single time. We have to practice this. And then after we have these three questions in front of us, once we have the answer to these three questions, the next part is that we thank Allah now through three ways. The first is through the heart. The second is through the tongue. And the third is through the body part, the physical body parts. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability and make us amongst the servants of Allah, wa thankful to Allah in times of difficulty, in times of easiness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us paradise in this world. And also make our life paradise, like paradise in this world. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us paradise in the hereafter. Subhanallah, bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa aqulu qawli hadha, walhamdulillah.